Gadata, Shiva Sadigur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're speaking from the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, from the second part, describing Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, and how he travels to different places. And he was traveling using a mantra given to him by his guru. And this mantra was a meditation on Madangopal. So by the power of the mantra, he went to higher planets in the universe, and then he went to places beyond the universe. He went to the abode of liberation, which is beyond the universe, and he met Lord Shiva there. And he also met some people from Vaikuntha, and they told him about Vaikuntha. So he came to visit Vaikuntha. So in Vaikuntha, he met with the Lord of Vaikuntha, the Supreme Lord Narayan. And Lord Narayan also has his consorts, Rama Devi and Bhumi Devi, and there's also Ananta Shesha and Garuda. They're all associates of Lord Narayan.
Ananta Shesha Garuda, 他们都是 Narayan 的同游.
So sometimes though, when he's in Vaikuntha, although he's in Vaikuntha, sometimes he feels discouraged, that he doesn't feel the same pleasure which he used to feel when he worships Lord Gopal.
在Vaikuntha他有的时候感到气馁，因为他并没有感受到当他崇拜Gopal的时候一样的快乐。Because
when he's with Gopal, there's very special pastimes which he enjoys with Lord Gopal. How they play with each other and how they embrace each other. But nothing like that is there in Vaikuntha. So when Gop Kumar would begin to think about Gopal, and he would feel, a little dissatisfaction, at that time, he would see that Lord Narayan would become Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj.
感觉到内心感觉到不满意的时候，当他想念勾炮的时候，他发现 Narayana 就变成了 Krishna， Nanda Maharaj 的儿子 Krishna。
And the two consorts of Lord Narayan, Lakshmi or Ramadevi, and also Bhumi, they would become the gopis, Radha and Chandravali.
Narayan 的两位伴侣 Ramadevi 和 Bhumi 就变成了两位 gopi, Radharani 和 Chandravali.
And all the assistants of Lord Narayan, all the people around him who were serving him, they would all become like young cowherd boys of Vrindavan.
在主 Narayan 四周的他的同游他的助手仆人变成了 Vrindavan 的牧牛童。
So, how did it happen that these persons all transformed into Krishna Leela. From Vaikuntha they became Krishna and Krishna's devotees. It happened because Lord Narayan is in everyone's heart. He knows everything. He knows what everyone is thinking.
那到底是怎么发生的呢？为什么 Vaikuntha 上面的这些人物转变成了Vrindavan 的这些人物呢，变成了 Krishna 的奉献者呢？那是因为主 Narayana 他处在每一个人的众生心中，他知道每一个生物的想法。
So he knew that Gopkumar's mind was disturbed and that he was thinking about Vrindavan.
他知道 Gopkumar 的心意变得不安不稳起来了。他在思念 Vrindavan.
So Lord Narayan, he made these arrangements to take away Gopkumar's anxiety.
因此主 Narayan 就做出了这些安排，以便拿走 Gopkumar 的焦虑。
But still, Gopkumar would still feel sad because he couldn't see Gopal, he couldn't play like they used to do in Vrindavan.
但是 Gopkumar 仍然感到伤心，因为他不能跟 Gopal 一起玩耍，就像在 Vrindavan 时候的样子。
Sometimes in the gardens, while he was there in Vaikuntha, he would be in the gardens of Lord Narayan, and he would see Lord Narayan there, just like as if he was in Vrindavan. He would be there there would be.Cows in the garden, and there'd be herds of cows, and it would just be like he was there in front of Vrindavan, but actually it was Vaikuntha.
在 Vaikuntha 的花园里，在那里呢，他就发现呢，在那里也有牛，他就可以像 Vrindavan 一样。放牛，跟 so it's like a 就好像在 Vrindavan 一样。
Yeah. And sometimes you would see also Lord Narayan sitting on the throne in Vaikuntha, in his palace, sitting on the throne, looking very splendid. But he would look just like Gopal.
有的时候发现呢，主 Narayan 呢坐在，国王四射的宝座上，浑身散发着熠熠光彩，但是看上去呢就好像 Gopal 一样。
So Gopkumar would sometimes see Madan Gopal in these different in different places. Although it's Vaikuntha, he would be thinking he'd be.Seeing Madan Gopal, his deity from Vrindavan.
所以 Gopkumar 在不同的地方看到的都是 Madan Gopal. 虽然他现在在 Vaikuntha, 但是他却在每个地方都看到了他在 Vrindavan 所崇拜的神像 Madan Gopal。
So, so Gopkumar knows that he's in Vaikuntha and that he's with the personality of Godhead, and that the mood in Vaikuntha is to show respect and reverence for the Lord.
Gopal Kumar 知道自己身在 Vaikuntha 和人格守神待在一起，在 Vaikuntha 的心态呢，是对主怀着尊敬和畏惧的心态。
So this would disturb Gopal Kumar's pure love for the Lord, because Gopkumar, he loves the Lord without thinking that he's God. He just thinks of the Lord as, you know, as a cowherd boy in Vrindavan. But this, in Vaikuntha, you have to think of the Lord as the supreme God, the one above everyone.
这就打扰了 Gopkumar 对主的纯粹的爱，因为在 Vrindavan, 人们不想主是神，只是把他当成文大文的牧牛童而已。而在 Vaikuntha 呢，他是至尊主为了每一个人，他高高在上。
So when Gopkumar would think of Madan Gopal, he wouldn't have the same Vaikuntha mood. He wouldn't have so much respect, and because he's thinking more in the mood of Vrindavan, where there's intimacy.
当 Gopal Madan Gopal 当 Gopal Kumar 这样思念 Madan Gopal 的时候呢，他的心态就和 Vaikuntha 的心态不一样了。因为在 Vrindavan 呢，人们的跟主的关系是非常亲密的关系。
But the mood of Vaikuntha, it stopped Gopkumar from having that kind of natural love for the Lord.
在 Vaikuntha 上的这种心态就阻止了 Gopkumar 对主的自发的爱。
When Gopkumar would do his mantra meditation, when he would meditate on Lord Gopal, then sometimes in his meditation, he would have different experiences with Madan Gopal. The Lord would embrace him and they would have very intimate dealings. He'd feel the mercy of the Lord.
当他在做自己的 mantra 冥想的时候，在冥想 Gopal 的时候，他就体验到了 Madan Gopal 有的时候会拥抱他，跟他有非常亲密的交流，他就体验到了 Madan Gopal 的仁慈。
But in Vaikuntha, he couldn't feel the same mercy. It wasn't the same mood. The mercy wasn't there like in Vrindavan.
然而在 Vaikuntha, 是不一样的仁慈，有不一样的心态，跟 Vrindavan 的仁慈不一样。
With Lord Narayan, you cannot embrace him, and you cannot joke, you cannot have, you know, talk, intimate talks so much with him. You just have to be from a keep away from a distance and speak to him with great respect.
你跟主拿拉呢，你是没办法拥抱他，没办法跟他开玩笑，和他有亲密的交谈，你必须得跟他保持距离，对他心怀敬意。
And sometimes Lord Narayan would go away somewhere secretly. He would just go with a few very intimate associates. And when he was away, then everyone would lament that Lord Narayan is not here.
有的时候呢，主拿瑞呢还会跟一些亲密的同游就悄悄地离开了。但这每当这种时候，在瓦昆呢，每个人都感到非常的伤心。
Yeah, when Lord Narayan is gone, then people they think, oh, where did our master go? They feel very unhappy and they feel the separation. But then, next moment, he will come back.
每当这时候呢，白昆塔上面的人们就在想，我们的主人 Narayan 去哪里了？然后他们会感到闷闷不乐，感到跟主 Narayan 的分离之情。但下一时刻呢，主又回来了。
And when Gop Kumar would ask, "What? Where did the Lord go? What's he doing?" Then nobody would answer. They said, "So they said, no, we can't discuss this."
嗯 ，Gopa Kumar 就会问，我们的主人去了哪里？他在做什么？可是呢，没有人回答他的问题。
No, because it's not respectful to inquire about the Lord's private times, what he does in private. So you have to show respect for the Lord Vaikuntha. You cannot talk about his private activities. So the Lord would go away, then he would reappear, and when he would come back, when he would reappear, then everybody would feel very happy again, and there would be no more lamentation.
之后呢，主又再次的显现了。每当这时候呢，所有人都会再次快乐起来，没有人，他们的悲伤呢也一扫而空。
So it sounds like there's some unhappiness there in Vaikuntha, but actually there's no unhappiness.
听上去好像是在瓦昆那有一些不快乐，但事实上呢，在瓦昆那是不存在不快乐的。
Because the Lord's absence was only for a moment. It's a very, very, very brief time, because time in Vaikuntha is very different from time here.
因为主他的他离开只是片刻的功夫，是非常短暂的，而在 Vaikuntha 上面的时间呢，跟我们在这里的时间是完全不一样的。
As soon as the devotees felt distress, immediately the Lord comes back. He's there.
每当奉献者感到不快乐的时候呢，主便立刻就回来了。
But a moment in Vaikuntha is a very big span of time in the material world.
在 Vaikuntha 上面的片刻时光，可是物质世界的一个很长的一个时间段。
In the Bhagavatam, it describes that the duration of Brahma's life, you know, Lord Brahma lives for 100 years, which is a very long time in terms of time of our world. But that duration of his life is less than a second for the spiritual world, for Krishna.
在《薄伽瓦坛》当中呢，就讲述了 Brahma 的一生，他的寿命，他也活100年，但是我们在这个地方比地球上的时间是相当长的一段时间。但是即便是 Brahma 的这一生和百坤的时间比起来，也是不到片刻的时间。
Time in Vaikuntha doesn't reduce the life of people in Vaikuntha.
Vaikuntha 上面的光阴，它不会减少 Vaikuntha 居民的寿命。
everybody in Vaikuntha has an eternal body, so there's no question of them growing old or dying.
在 Vaikuntha 上，所有的生物他们都拥有永恒的躯体，不存在变老、死亡的问题。
So the effect of time does not, it doesn't cause the deterioration of the elements, because everything in the Vaikuntha is spiritual, there's nothing material. In the material world, time degrades everything, but there's nothing material in the spiritual world.
在 Vaikuntha 上面呢，它的时间不会让所有的元素变得衰败衰退，因为 Vaikuntha 上 Vaikuntha 一切都是灵性的，而不是物质的，因此不存在衰退的问题。
So sometimes Gopkumar would be, his mind would become disturbed. He'd be thinking about Vrindavan. His mind would become disturbed.
有的时候。Gopakumar 的心意因为思念 Vrindavan 就会感到不安。
But then he would remember about Vaikuntha, that he's here in the spiritual world in Vaikuntha, and he would see all the opulence of Vaikuntha, and it would take away all his depression or anxiety or separation from Vrindavan.
但是他又再次想起了他现在身在 Vaikuntha， 而 Vaikuntha 上面是这么的富裕，所以这些想法呢就拿走了他的闷不乐、焦虑、他的不快乐。
So whenever he would feel this kind of depression in his mind, he would remember that he's actually very fortunate. He's in the spiritual world.
所以，当他的心意，每当他心意感觉到有一些抑郁、压抑的时候，他一转念一想，他又感觉到自己非常的幸运，因为他现在已经在灵性世界了。
But at the same time, that the depression he felt was going to help him to go on to the higher world, because it's a world higher than Vaikuntha.And that is, of course, Goloka. That is the supreme planet in the spiritual sky.
但是这种抑郁就帮助他进一步前行，去高等、更高等的世界 ，Goloka Vrindavan， 因为那里是整个的灵性世界最高的星球。
But still, Vaikuntha had a powerful influence on Gopkumar and it stopped him from feeling very much distress.
但是 Vaikuntha 他拥有这个奇妙的力量，能够让 Gopakumar 不再感觉到难过伤心。
And because he was intelligent, he knew that his problem was that he wanted to go to a place beyond even Vaikuntha. He knew that he had reached Vaikuntha, he would feel some satisfaction. But...He knew that satisfaction would only be for a short time.
他知道自己在在百昆特上，他也会感到一些许的满足感，但这种满足感呢是非常短暂的。
So he would preach to his mind. He would talk to his mind. Gopkumar would tell his mind that.There's no better place, more desirable place to be than Vaikuntha. So we should have no doubt that you're in the best place.
每当这时候呢，他就向自己的心意传教，就告诉他的自己的心意，没有比外坤达更好的地方，没有比这个外坤达是更令人向往的地方了。所以不用怀疑，这是最好的地方。
The Vedas say that there's no better place than Vaikuntha to be.
因为韦达经声称声明，没有比外坤达更好的地方。
So he would talk to his mind that should forget about any dissatisfaction. Just be happy here. You're in a very good place.
他就告诉自己的心里，把这些不满意都忘掉吧，就在这里感到快乐就好了。
And then he would think how he's got Gop Kumar. Of course, when he came to Vaikuntha, in order to come to Vaikuntha, they had to give him a spiritual body. Spiritual body means a Satchidananda body, full of eternity, knowledge, and bliss. So he would see himself in the Satchidananda body, and he would see the happiness and the pleasure of Vaikuntha.
Gopa Kumar, 他看到自己现在已经拥有一具灵性的躯体了，就是用 Satchit Ananda, 永恒知识和极乐的身体。他也看到在Vaikuntha呢，一切都是快乐的。
Yeah, he would see, he would think how he's so fortunate, he's able to take part in worshipping the Lord in Vaikuntha.
他会看到自己是多么幸运，有幸能够参与崇拜 Vaikuntha 之主。
So he stayed in Vaikuntha. Sometimes he'll feel pleasure, and sometimes he will feel disturbed.
Gopa Kumar 在 Vaikuntha 上面，有时候感觉到快乐，可是有时候就感觉到不安。
Then one day Narada Muni found him, and he was.Gop Kumar was in a quiet place. Narada Muni came to him, and Narada Muni put his hand on Gop Kumar's head.
有一天 ，Narada Muni 来了。当 Gopa Kumar 在一个安静僻静的地方 ，Narada Muni 来，把他的手放在了 Gopa Kumar 的头顶。
So Gop Kumar has great respect for Narada Muni because he knows Narada Muni is he's an intimate associate of the Lord, and he has also a lot of spiritual knowledge.
Gopa Kumar 是对于 Narada Muni 是满怀敬意，他知道 Narada Muni 是主的亲密同游，拥有。
So Narada Muni says to Gop Kumar that, you know, you've got the mercy of the Lord of Vaikuntha. You're the son of a cowherd boy, but you've got the mercy of the Lord of Vaikuntha.
Narada Muni 对 Gopa Kumar 说，你得到了 Vaikuntha 之主的仁慈。虽然你只是一名牧牛童，可是你却得到了 Vaikuntha 之主的仁慈。
But when I look at your face, you look depressed. You look like you're suffering due to some problem. You don't look very happy.
可是看一看你的面容，看看你的脸，好像你在因为某些问题你感到很痛苦一样，你并没有感觉到快乐。
So Narada Muni could understand what was happening. He knew something's wrong with Gop Kumar just by seeing him.
So Narada Muni, 呢他就一看 Gopa Kumar 的脸就知道有些不对劲的地方。
So Narada Muni is puzzled, and he asked Gop Kumar, he said, how can there be any pain? There's no pain or sorrow here.This is Vaikuntha. How can you be in pain?
Narada Muni 就感觉到有些困惑，他就问他，在百坤的上面你怎么会感到痛苦，感到难过悲伤呢？
I've never seen anybody here in Vaikuntha in a condition like what you are.
我在百坤塔上从来没有见过过哪个人有处在你现在的这种境况下。
Gop Kumar may say, well, I'm just unhappy. But Narada would say, well, how can you be unhappy? Nobody's unhappy here in Vaikuntha.
因为 Gopa Kumar 回答说他感到不快乐。Narada Muni 就反问道，你怎么会不快乐呢？在此地没有人不快乐呀。
Yeah, there's no pain, there's no suffering in Vaikuntha. How can you be unhappy?
在 Vaikuntha 在这里呢，没有人感觉到痛苦，没有人感觉到苦难的问题，所以你怎么会不快乐呢？
So Gop Kumar was thinking, I'm very fortunate to have this meeting with Narada Muni, because Narada Muni is a very powerful authority.
幸运，因为他是一位有力量的权威。
He's equal to being the Shiksha Guru of Gop Kumar. He's like his Shiksha Guru. He's a friend. He has a nice friendly dealing with him. And he's full of knowledge. So Gop Kumar can take him like a Shiksha Guru.
Because Narada Muni, he treats Gop Kumar very kindly. Their communication is very good.所以 Gopa Kumar 就把 Narada Muni 当成他的 Shiksha Guru 训示 Guru。
Or he's even as good as the Diksha Guru.
就像启迪 Guru Diksha Guru 是一样的。
So Gop Kumar is ready to reveal everything in his heart to tell Narada Muni what he's feeling, what his problem is.
所以 Gopa Kumar 就准备向 Narada Muni 揭示自己的内心，袒露他的心声，到底出现了什么问题，他的感受如何。
So Gopa Kumar tells him a story about how he's, you know, missing Madan Gopal. He's come from Vrindavan and he misses all the intimacy, all the pastimes. And Narada Muni hears it all.
所以 Gopa Kumar 就向 Narada Muni 袒露了自己的故事，他是如何思念 Madan Gopal 的。他是来自 Vrindavan 的，他和Gopal 呢有亲密的逍遥时光，所以 Narada Muni 就详细的聆听了。
Narada Muni also thinks himself unfortunate to be able to go to the world above Vaikuntha.
Narada Muni also thinks himself unfortunate.
Yeah, because Narada Muni also can't go to Goloka, to the place above Vaikuntha. You know, Gop Kumar, he was thinking that he's unfortunate, he wants to go to the place above Vaikuntha. So Narada Muni also feels like that.
So, 但是他现在没有去那里，他觉得自己很不幸。同样的 ，Narada Muni 也感到自己，他也有同样的不幸的感受。
So when he heard Gop Kumar speak like that, Narada Muni became a bit sad.
当他听到 Gopa Kumar 是这样的一番话之后，他就感到内心很难过。
But he didn't admit it. He wants to hide that. He doesn't want Gop Kumar to know that Narada Muni doesn't want Gop Kumar to know that he's also feeling that same distress.
可是拿着目的他不想承认，因为他不希望我帕库马尔知道他内心呢也有这种这种悲伤的感受。
So Narada Muni, he gets, calls Gop Kumar, come closer. He wants to tell him, he wants to give him special mercy. He wants to tell him about special things, confidential things.
Narada Muni 呢就让 Gop Kumar 就靠近一点，因为他想给予他特殊的仁慈，想告诉他一些机密的事情。
So Narada Muni says, actually, there's nothing higher than Vaikuntha. If we do logical, by logical analysis, we could understand there's nothing higher than Vaikuntha.
Narada Muni 对 Gopal Kumar 说道，实际上呢没有什么比Vaikuntha 没有哪个地方比 Vaikuntha 更高的地方了。如果从逻辑上分析一下，就能得出这个结论。
And he said, I know that when you do your meditation, you see all these pastimes of the Lord in your meditation, and you want to see these pastimes here in Vaikuntha.
我知道。你在冥想的时候呢，你看到了主的逍遥时光，你想在百昆塔这里也看到主的这个逍遥时光。
You want to see them with your own eyes. You're seeing them in your mind when you do your meditation, but you want to see them with your own eyes.
你现在想亲眼看到这些逍遥时光，所以当你冥想的时候，你是在心意当中看到的。可是你现在是想亲眼看见。
But in order to actually see these things, you have to have the highest, you have to come to the highest level of love of God.
为了能够看到目睹这一幕呢，你必须要达到对神的最高的爱的层面。
You have to develop love like the residents of Vrindavan.
你需要发展 Vrindavan 的居民的爱。
These pastimes which you're meditating, which you're seeing in your meditation, they can never be seen by people like me, Narada Muni says.
Narada Muni 说道，你希望见到的那种逍遥时光呢，像我这样的人是看不见的。
So there is a certain world above all others where these pastimes are to be seen.
有一个世界他超越了所有的地方，在那里可以见到这个逍遥时光。
By your devotion for the Lord, you have come to Vaikuntha.
因为你对主的奉爱之情，所以你来到了百昆塔。
So how can you see these pastimes? How can you see those pastimes here? This is a different place.
你怎么能指望在这里能见到那样的逍遥时光呢？因为这是和那个世界不同的一个地方。
Narada tells him, you know, these pastimes are not going on here in Vaikuntha. They go on in another place, a supreme place above Vaikuntha.
Narada Muni 告诉他，那样的逍遥时光是不会发生在这里的，而是发生在至高无上的、超越了百昆塔的地方。
And that place is very unique, very secret. To go there, you have to have special qualification.
方是独一无二的，是非常至为机密的。想要去的那个地方需要有特殊的仁慈。
So Gop Kumar will have to prepare himself if he wants to go there, if he wants to enter in there.
倘若 Gopa Kumar 希望去那里进入那个地方，他必须让自己做好准备。
That place has a different mood from Vaikuntha.
那个地方是拥有和 Vaikuntha 不一样的心态。
You have to develop very special loving friendship with the Lord to go there.
为了去那里，必须发展起跟主之间特殊的爱的友谊关系。
But here in Vaikuntha, we only know the Lord's opulence. We don't know about this very secret place.
可是在 Vaikuntha 这里呢，我们只知道主的富裕，我们并不了解那个秘密的地方。
So Narada Muni tells Gop Kumar, just stop all this lamentation. Just see the Lord of Vaikuntha as the same person, as the same person as Madan Gopal. Don't think they're different. They're the same.
Narada Muni 就对 Gop Kumar 说，你停止你的悲伤吧，你就把主拿让人看成跟 Madan Gopal 是同样的人，不要把他们看成是不一样的人。
So Narada Muni is telling Gop Kumar, your mind will be peaceful if you can understand Lord Narayan is the same as Madan Gopal.
Narada Muni 就告诉 Gopal Kumar, 当你把主拿让人和Madan Gopal 看成是一个人的时候，你就会感到心意平和了。
And if you think like that, then even here in, when you're here in Vaikuntha, you will also be happy and you will experience bliss.
如果你这样去想，有这种想法，这种念头的话，你就会感到快乐，你就会感到体验到极乐。
And that bliss will also increase. It will go on increasing more and more. The joy, the pleasure, of, it's not limited, but it's dynamic. It's always increasing.
那种极乐还会不断的增加，这种没有无边无际的喜乐之情，它是不断增长着的，而且是充满着活力的。
So Gop Kumar wants Narada Muni to explain some things to him. He wants to know certain, he wants Narada Muni to explain certain things which he's been seeing here in the spiritual world.
Gop Kumar 希望 Narada Muni 给他解释他现在在灵性世界所看到的某些事情。
Right.So he wants to understand more about Vaikuntha, how there's so many different species, different varieties of living entities.
他希望Gopa Kumar 希望了解为什么百昆特上面会有不同的生物种类。
Narada Muni is, Gop Kumar is very shy and very respectful. He didn't like to ask the question, but Narada Muni knew what he was thinking.
Gop Kumar 他天性害羞，而且他心怀敬意，Narada Muni 知道他不想提问题。
No, Gop Kumar 不想提问题。
Gopal Kumar 不想提问题。
But Narada Muni could understand what he was thinking.
但是 Narada Muni 呢，知道他的想法。
So Narada Muni explained each of the things which Gop Kumar was thinking about.
所以呢 ，Narada Muni 就把 Gopal Kumar 他心意里所想的问题呢，一一的解答了。
He wants to give pleasure to the ears of Gop Kumar.
他想给 Gopal Kumar 的耳朵快乐。
So Narada Muni tells Gop Kumar, he said.You should understand that all the animals and the birds and the trees and the bushes and the grass, everything here, that they're not made from earth.
Narada Muni 呢就对他说道，你要明白，在这里的动物、鸟类、树木。灌木丛以及草都不是由泥土所构成的。
They're not like ordinary creatures in the material world, which are in the mode of ignorance.
他们并不像物质世界那些普通的处在愚昧属性当中的生物。
Gop Kumar had come to Vaikuntha, he had seen many animals.Horses, elephants, he saw all the birds, and different plants, he saw even insects and worms.
Gopal Kumar 在百坤塔上面看到了有各种各类的动物，马匹、大象、鸟类、植物、昆虫，甚至那些小爬虫。
So in material world, when we see these things, we think, oh, they're very, you know, they've misused their independence, so this is their bad karma, they've got a body like this.
当我们在物质世界看到上述的这些生物体的时候，我们就会想，哦，他们误用了他们的独立、自由，他们这是因为他们的恶报。所以他们才拥有现在的这样的躯体。
But in Vaikuntha, all these living entities are not like that. They're all pure souls. They're all, and they have Satchidananda bodies.
在 Vaikuntha 上面不是这样子的，因为他们都是纯粹的灵魂，他们拥有的是 Satchidananda, 永恒知识快乐的形体。
They're all personal associates of Lord Krishna.
他们都是主 Krishna 的亲身同游。
And they assume these forms, of the different forms, different creatures, just to serve Krishna in different ways.
他们之所以会有各种各类的躯体，是因为他们以这种形式在服务主 Krishna.
They want to give pleasure to Krishna through these different forms.
他们希望能通过不同种类的生物的形体，能给 Krishna 带来快乐。
The birds, their color and their singing gives pleasure to Krishna.
鸟类的，它们不同的。身体的色彩以及他们的歌喉都给 Krishna 带来快乐。
And then different trees, they give shade, and they give fruit, they give flowers, they give pleasure to Krishna.
不同的树木，他们用他们的树荫、花朵，给 Krishna 带来了果实，给 Krishna 带来了快乐。
So everything in the spiritual world is there simply for the pleasure of Krishna, and they're all Satchidananda.
在灵性世界上面的一切都是为了 Krishna 的快乐，他们都是 Satchidananda, 永恒知识快乐的。
And they take these different forms with different colors and different shapes.
所以他们就出以各种各类的形象，各色彩缤纷的颜色，以及各种的不同的形象来出现。
And these forms are also related to the form of the Lord, which they used to worship, which they worship.
这些都跟他们崇拜的主，主的形象有密切的关系。
So they, when they come to the spiritual world, before they come to the spiritual world, they worship the Lord, Lord Narayan.In these different forms.
在他们来到灵修世界之前，他们都是以借以不同的形象在崇拜着主拿拉耶。
So they get these kind of forms in the spiritual world.
因此，他们在灵性世界也得到了这类的形象。
They get.Form similar to the Lord, and they enjoy also the opulence of these different bodies.
他们得到跟主同样的形象，并且享受的富裕也是跟主享受的富裕一样的。
Some have become hogs. Hog, you know, pig. Some have become, yeah, some have become dwarf.Some have become man lions, and some like that.
就有些生物呢，就变成了雄猪的样子，有些呢变成了侏儒的样子，而有些是变成了半人半狮的样子。
And some have three eyes, some have four arms, and some have thousands of eyes, like the Mahapurush.
有三只眼睛，长着三只眼睛，而有的人呢，他有四臂，还有的是有一千只眼睛，就像马哈普鲁什一样。
And some have bodies with thousands of faces.
有些人他拥有一千张面孔的这样形象。
And some take the form of some of the different gods. Some take the form of the different gods, like the god of fire or the god of air. They take these forms.
还有的人呢，他们是拥有半神的形体，就像火神，还有掌管空气的半神的形象。
Some of them have four arms, some have eight arms, some have 12 arms, some have more.
有的人有四臂，有的是长着八臂，还有的十二臂吧，还有的是有更多的臂吧。
So many different dresses and ornaments.
穿着各式各样的衣服，还带着各式各样的饰品。
So inhabitants of Vrindavan, they can have this form. They can have.Human forms, but they can have other forms also.
Vrindavan 的居民呢，可以有人类的形象，也可以有其他的形象。
So there's so much variety there in Vaikuntha.
在 Vaikuntha 上面是有着。是种类繁多的。
Some are devotees of Lord Ramachandra, so they will get the human form when they come to Vaikuntha.
有些人呢是如 Ramachandra 的奉献者，他们就会获得在 Vaikuntha 上面获得一具人类的形象。
And some follow Lord Kapila, so they would get the body like a sage, like Lord Kapila.
而有些人呢是卡皮勒，就是卡皮勒的追随者，他们就会获得圣人的形体。
And some are worshipping Lord Parasurama. You get the body of a fish.
果一个人他是住 Matsya 的奉献者，他就会获得一个鱼的形体。
If you worship Lord Kurma, you may get in the spiritual world, may get tortoise body.
或者，倘若一个人他是 Kurma 的奉献者，他在灵性世界呢，就会获得一个一只乌龟的形体。
And if we worship Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, we worship them as a representative of the Supreme Lord, then you can get a body like Shiva or Brahma when you go there.
或者倘若一个人是主 Shiva, Brahma 的奉献者，因为他们是代表着主，
right.
那他在灵性世界就会得到像 Shiva, Brahma 那样的形体。
Lord Shiva has three eyes and five heads.
主 Shiva 他长着三只眼，五个头。
Lord Brahma in this universe has four heads, but other universes has many heads.
在这个宇宙当中的主 Brahma 是四个头颅，而在其他的宇宙是有更多的头颅。
And somebody may worship Indra as the representative of the Supreme Lord, and they may get the body like Indra, which is covered with eyes, 1,000 eyes.
有的人呢是把主 Indra 当成了至尊主的代表来崇拜，他在灵性世界就会获得像主 Indra 那样的形象，有1,000只眼睛，他的身体。
Or like Ananta. Like Anantashesh, you have thousands of heads.
或者是像 Anantashesh 那样有1,000个头盆。
Or you may get body like, if you worship Surya, the sun god, as a representative, you may get a body like him. Like fire, fountains.
倘若是崇拜 Surya,光芒四射的太阳神苏叶的话，那会在灵性世界呢，就会获得像苏叶那样光芒四万丈的躯体。
Anyway, everyone who goes to Vaikuntha, they have to have pure love for the lotus feet of the Lord.
无论如何，去百昆特上面的人都必须对主怀着纯粹无暇的爱。
You cannot go just by worshipping demigods alone, but if you see the demigod as a representative of the Supreme Lord, then you can do.
只是单独的崇拜半神人是不能去百昆特的，必须要把半神人当作至尊人格守神的代表来崇拜才可以。
Just like we talk about Lord Shiva,that he's related to Vishnu, he's like yogurt, and Vishnu is the milk.
正如我们以前说过，主 Shiva, 他是 Vishnu 的代表，他就像酸奶，他们的关系就像酸奶和牛奶之间的关系。
So there are some Vaikuntha planets where the devotees get the opulence, these differentopulences of the demigods, although they're in the Vaikuntha planet.
所以在灵性世界呢，有的人就会奉献者就会得到就像半神人那样的富裕。
So this way we're understanding how there's so much variety there in the spiritual world.
以这种方式我们就能够明白在灵性世界呢是丰富多彩的。
Some people have bodies that demigods like Yamaraj, they get a body like Yamaraj.
还有的奉献者呢拥有像阎罗王 Yamaraj 那样的躯体。
Because Yamaraj has the power of the Supreme Lord. So people worship Yamaraj, they can respect him as being this, you know, representative of the Lord.
因为阎罗王 Yamaraj 他像至尊主，他是至尊主的代表，那像至尊主的代表那样有力量，所以有的人就把阎罗王当作至尊主的代表来崇拜。
So whoever comes to Vaikuntha, they've developed some service attitude to the lotus feet of Krishna, and they have a particular mood, so they bring that with them when they come to this Vaikuntha.
无论谁要是去 Vaikuntha, 必须要发展对至尊主 Krishna 莲花族的服务的心态，他们就会带着特定的心态去 Vaikuntha。
So each and every devotee have their own mood for the service of the Lord.
每一位奉献者都有独一无二的对主的特定的心态。
So they bring that mood there with them to Vaikuntha. So that's why there's so many different bodies, different species of life there.
他们就会携带着不同各类的心态去百昆塔，所以在百昆塔上面就有各式各类的躯体，各式各类的种类。
So some people in Vaikuntha, they have human bodies, and some have monkey bodies, and some have demon bodies.
在百昆塔上面，有的奉献者是拥有人类的形体。有的是猴子的形体，还有的是恶魔的形体。
But they don't have a body like the Lord. They don't get the body like Lord Ramachandra, like Kapila did.
他们是不会获得像主 Ramachandra, 像主 Kapila did 那样同样的一模一样的形体的。
They practice devotional service.In their material life, and the devotees develop their love for God, and they begin to display symptoms of their perfection, their attraction to a particular form of the Lord.
他们在物质世界修习对主的奉爱服务，发展起对神的爱。在灵性世界就会展示出特定的对主的特定的形象的完美的吸引。
So they each have their own individual rasa with the Lord, and they bring that with them when they come to Vaikuntha.
他们每一个人都和至尊主有一种个体性的 rasa, 因此他们就会把这个个体性的 rasa 就带到外空头。
And it gives a lot of pleasure to the Lord to see all the variety, all the different moods of devotion.
当至尊主看到他们有着千差万别的种类，还有着千差万别的心态的时候。
And sometimes for the pleasure of the Lord, in Vaikuntha, the devotee there may imitate the activities of a demigod in the material world.
为了在Vaikuntha上面，为了Vaikuntha之主的快乐，那里的奉献者有的时候会模仿在物质世界。
Because everything is in Vaikuntha, it's in a pure form. The perverted form, the contaminated form, polluted form is here in the material world. But everything which is here in this world is there in the spiritual world in its pure form.
Because in Vaikuntha, it's pure.纯粹无瑕的形体，无论在物质世界有着怎样的歪曲的、受到污染的，这样的形象， 在灵性世界是拥有纯粹无瑕的形象。
Okay, we're going to stop there now. We're going to stop. Any questions?
好，接下来我们来回答问题。第一个问题，喜宝，顶拜咕噜和老师们节日快乐。在阅读咕噜讲课的《爱的觉醒》一书中，体验到阅读和聆听圣典博伽瓦谈是灵性的。我今天提问有两个：一，我年老体衰的母亲是个无神论者，心中装满物质忧虑，很多都是我过去无知作恶的时候带给他的伤害。请问，如果我现在在母亲不反对的情况下，给他阅读圣典和念诵圣名，这个会不会平息他内心的痛苦和矛盾呢？Obeisance Guru and teachers, Happy Festival. I have read your book, The Awakening of Love, and I have experienced that listening to the Bhagavatam is spiritual. Today I have two questions. The first one, my old mother is an atheist, and in her heart, full of material anxiety, and many is due to my misdeeds to her in the past. Because of my sinful misdeeds, I have hurt her in the past. My question is that if I read Sasha and chant holy name to her, can this pacify her suffering and contradiction in her heart?
Well, it can do if your mother is willing to hear.
如果您的母亲愿意聆听的话是可以的。
I don't know if, because you say your mother is an atheist, I don't know if she'd be willing to hear.
您说您母亲是无神论者，我不知道您母亲愿不愿意聆听。
But if she can, if somehow you can get her to hear, certainly it would be good for her.
但是如果你能够让她聆听的话，那肯定会对她带来好处的。
If she does not want to hear the books, maybe she can hear the mantra.
如果她不想聆听圣典，也许他会愿意聆听 mantra。
Let her hear the chanting of the holy name。
最好是让他聆听唱诵圣名。
Just tell her this is very special medicine。
就告诉他这是特殊的药物。
Will protect her from evil forces。
这会保护他不受那些邪恶力量的影响。
So if you can hear the holy name, that's very wonderful.
如果他能够聆听到圣名的话，那是相当奇妙的。
We wish you good luck in your preaching to your mother.
我们希望您对您的母亲的传教会获得成功。我们希望您好运，祝您好运。
Yeah, 好运。Okay.
下 ，the next part of the question is also from, well, there are four question mark in the in this question. So the next part is.我们现在应该以什么心态来祈祷 Radharani 和 Krishna 的仁慈呢？ So in what mood should we pray for the mercy of Radharani and Krishna? Or should we 是把他们当作宇宙至尊主来崇拜祈祷呢？还是把我们自己作为叛逆之后迷途知返的孩子，哭喊着呼唤宇宙至尊父母的宽恕和照顾呢？ Should we worship and pray for their mercy as the universal supreme Lord, or should we regard ourselves as lost child who has rebellious spirit and cry for the caring and forgiveness of our universal supreme parents? Thank you.
Yeah, I like the second one. Very nice. To cry for our supreme universal parents.
是按照第二种来去做，就是把他们当作宇宙的至尊父母来请求他们的宽恕和照顾。
What was the first one? What did she say? The first one?
In what mood should we pray for the mercy of Radharani and Krishna?And then she gave two options.
Yeah, the first one was?
The first one was to worship them. And to worship them and offering prayers to them as the supreme, the universal supreme Lord.
No, the second one is better.
不是第一种，就是第二种更好。
Thinking them as their parents, and we are the child who gone away from their shelter, and we coming back with a repentant heart.
把他们当作父母，我们自己是有着逆反心理的孩子，然后现在呢，我们满怀着忏悔之情。又来到他们跟前。
But we would encourage you to approach Lord Chaitanya, because Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful of all Krishna's forms. He comes to give mercy to people, very fallen people in this age of Kali. So it'sNice to approach Lord Chaitanya and get mercy from him, rather than try to go to Radha and Krishna, who are more difficult to approach.
我们更鼓励您接近主 Chaitanya, 因为主 Chaitanya 是这个年代最仁慈的神的化身，他在Kali年代降临。前来给予堕落灵魂以仁慈，所以接近主柴坦尼亚更好，而不是去找 Radha Krishna， 去接近 Radha Krishna 是很难的。
But through the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, then we can approach Radha and Krishna.
通过主柴坦尼亚的仁慈。之后可以去接近 Radha Krishna.
We approach Lord Chaitanya through Lord Nityananda.
而我们是通过主尼迦南达来接近主 Chaitanya.
Lord Nityananda.Is the form of the spiritual master. And by the mercy of the spiritual master, you get the mercy of Krishna.
Through the 灵性导师的仁慈, 你才能够得到主 Krishna 的仁慈。
So, you might consider praying to Lord Nityananda, and then to Lord Chaitanya, and then to Radha and Krishna.
You might considering
pray for might, pray first.
Oh, okay. 所以您可以考虑就向主 Nityananda 祈祷，然后呢向主 Chaitanya 祈祷。
Don't try to approach Radha Krishna directly. Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题。下一个问题是说Panchapadva Das， 现在的初级奉献者如何追随 Vrindavan 的居民呢？ How can new fighters today follow the residents of Vrindavan？
Well, before we try to follow the residents of Vrindavan, we have to first of all follow the regulative principles. We have to be steady in the regulative principles. It's not for neophyte devotees to follow the residents of Vrindavan, but we have to first learn the regulative principles. We do Vaidhi Bhakti first. By doing Vaidhi Bhakti according to regulative principles, then we will come gradually to this stage of the spontaneous devotion, which is the mood of Vrindavan.
首先呢是要追随规范原则，在规范原则这些规范原则方面呢比较稳定之后呢，再去就对于初级奉献者来说，首先要追随规范原则。要学习规范原则 Vaidhi Bhakti， 怎么去从事 Vaidhi Bhakti， 之后稳定了之后再逐渐的上升到人大民族民族应有的自发的爱。
So spontaneous devotion will naturally come as we practice the regulative principles.
我们修习规范原则之后，自发的爱会自动的到来的。
You can read, for example, you can read the symptoms of one who is on the stage of bhava. There are, I think, 12 different characteristics of a devotee who has achieved the stage of bhava.
您可以阅读一下关于巴瓦的特征，就是有一共有12个特征巴瓦。
If you read in the Nectar of Devotion, the chapter on devotional service in ecstasy, the different principles of the different characteristics of Baba Bhakti are mentioned.
在奉纳的甘露当中。关于在狂喜当中程序奉献服务这一章就讲了 Bhakti 它拥有它是什么样的特征。
For example, very attached to the Holy Dham.
比如说十分依恋圣地。
Very much careful not to waste any time, not even a moment of time, to utilize every moment in the service of Krishna.
非常小心，不会浪费片刻的光阴，小心的用每分每秒都来服务 Krishna。
Very, very much attached to hearing the glories of the Lord described in the revealed scriptures and discussing with devotees the topics of the Lord。
去聆听启示经典当中描述的主的荣耀。并且和奉献者展开讨论。
So there are several other qualities you can look there in the nectar of devotion.
还有其他的几个品质资格，您可以在《奉爱的甘露》这本书当中去阅读。
We want to cultivate these kind of qualities to come to the stage of spontaneous devotion.
在达到自发的奉爱阶段之前，我们需要培养所有上述的资格品质。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是，淡然一笑，什么是宗教原则？分别跟非奉献者和奉献者该如何回答 ？What is the religious principle? How can I respond? Reply this question to non-devotees and devotees.
So, to non-devotees, you can explain that there are principles which are meant for helping people to keep good character.
对于非奉献者，你可以这样回答，就是宗教原则是帮助人们培养优良品格。
We see in the world people's characters, the character of people is very poor these days. They're not very honest, they're not very clean, they're very immoral.
我们看到在当今世界上人们的品格都很欠缺，人们不诚实，也没有清洁的品质，他们也不道德。
And they can be very cruel, they're not very kind.
他们非常冷酷无情，一点也不仁慈。
So religious principles are there to help us to reform our character, to try to cultivate good character.
宗教原则是为了帮助我们改造我们的不良品质、不良品格，让我们发展起优良的品格。
So someone may not be a devotee.But we hope he can appreciate the importance of having good character.
有些人他们不是奉献者，但是我们也希望他们能够对这些优良的品格非常的欣赏这些优良的品质。
And for people who are devotees, we can explain in more detail that religious principles.Are there to counteract all the bad qualities in the world?
对于奉献者呢，我们可以更加细，给予他们更加详细的阐释。宗教原则是能够中和，或者是能够反击世界上所有这些不良品格。
Just like we tell people, don't eat meat, fish, and eggs. So we say, if you want to cultivate the quality of mercy, it's very important that we should not kill animals.
就像我们告诉奉献者不要吃鱼肉蛋，但是如果希望培养仁慈的品质的话。就不能去杀戮动物。
And we also tell devotees don't take intoxication. Intoxication is ruining the lives of many people.
我们也告诫人们不要服用麻醉品，因为我们看到就是服用麻醉品就会把人们的生活。彻底毁掉。
And by taking intoxication, we lose any ability to control our senses.
服用了麻醉品之后呢，人们就没有能力来控制他们的感官了。
And we tell people cleanliness is very important, but cleanliness is destroyed by illicit sex.
我们也告诉人们清洁是非常重要的，但是从事非法的性生活就会毁坏清洁这个品质。
And to be truthful is another good quality, but because people gamble, they lose their quality of truthfulness.
诚实是另外一个优秀的、优良的品格，但是赌博就会使人们丧失这个诚实的、优良品格。
So like that, you can explain to people.
你可以以这种方式来向人们来解释。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是 ，Jopati Devadasi， 感谢敬爱的 Guru 的莲花族，听您讲述 Gopal Kumar 的经历，还是渴望 在 Goloka 与主轻松自然的关系。我们在物质世界为了活着需要做很多事情，在 Brahma Samhita 描述灵性世界的富裕，有如愿树、苏拉比奶牛，可以满足任何愿望，产出任何东西。那灵性的躯体意味着不需要维系，是吗？灵性世界奉献者一切都是为了取悦 Krishna， Krishna 是自足的，而奉献者和 Krishna 之间服务的关系只是为了上演消时光，主有需求服务，奉献者也不要也不需要饿了吃饭，这一切都是主的不可思议的神秘力量和 Yoga Maya 展现，这样理解对吗？So, obeisance, dear Guru, Guru's lotus feet. After hearing the experience of Gopal Kumar, still I hankering for that natural, relaxed relationship with the Lord in Goloka. In the material world, in order to maintain our life, we have to do many things. But in Brahma Samhita, it's described the opulence of the spiritual world. There are a kapha viksha tree, surabhi cows can satisfy any desires, can produce anything. But the spiritual body doesn't need to be maintained, is that right? And also in the spiritual world, everything devotee do is for leisure of Krishna, but Krishna is self-satisfied. The relationship between devotees and Krishna is for the pastime. The Lord don't need the service, and devotees don't need to eat due to hunger. This is all due to the inconceivable mystic power of the Lord and due to the manifestation of Yoga Maya. Is this understanding right?
Yes, I think so.
是的，我认为是对的。
Yeah, we don't need to eat in the spiritual world, but still, if Krishna invites us to eat, if Krishna likes company, it's a pastime, you know, it's to take prasadam there in the spiritual world. It's a pastime. Maybe we don't need to eat to maintain the body, but it's an activity for, you know, it's part of the pleasure of being with the devotees and being with Krishna, that you sit down and you eat together.
是的，这奉献者虽然不需要去吃饭，但是呢，主会邀请奉献者一起吃饭。同样呢，主也需要奉献者的陪伴，这都是荣耀菩萨的消时光。虽然就是奉献者奉献者他们为了 Krishna 的快乐，为了奉献者的快乐，他们会一起坐下来吃饭。
And you're right. Krishna is self-satisfied. He doesn't need us to please him, but we need to please Krishna. So Krishna gives us that opportunity.
嗯，您说的也很对，就是Krishna是自我满足的，他不需要别人来满足他。嗯，什么？你来说的。
We need to please Krishna.
但是我们是需要去取悦Krishna的。
So your understanding is all right, no problem. 下一个问题。
下一个问题是阿米顶拜咕噜的莲花族，我们在佛教经常立牌位超度祖先，希望他们生活的好些。那么在Krishna之节中，我们如何超度祖先呢？另外，报告咕噜。 现在我的烹饪技术有进步了，经常看菜谱，还有跟着奉献者学习。Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. So in Buddhism, they often always deliver their ancestor by setting up a symbol that to deliver those ancestors, and they hope they can have a better life. But in Krishna consciousness, how can we deliver our ancestor? Besides that, I want to report to Guru, now my skill of cooking prasadam achieved great progress. I often read manuals, and I learn from devotees.
Oh, I'm very pleased to hear Amy can cook very nicely, and you're learning from the devotees, and you're using recipes. That's very good. Please continue. Practice is very important in cooking.
听到阿米汇报说，阿米的烹饪技术，Amy，OK，sorry，Amy，你的烹饪技术有进步，并常看菜谱，还跟着奉献者学习，我感到非常的高兴。姑姑说她感到很开心，希望您继续看菜谱。
In relation to your question, how we can worship, how we can benefit our ancestors, the best thing is that we become good devotees ourselves. And by being a good devotee, all the ancestors will benefit.
有关于您说到怎么给祖先都带来好处的话，这是通过我们自己成为优秀的奉献者。如果我们自己成为优秀的奉献者，我们的祖先就会得到好处。Prahlad
Maharaj was worried about his father going to hell, but Lord Narsingadev said, "It's not a problem because Prahlad is such a great devotee." He said, "Not only your father, but for 21 generations, they're all delivered."
Prahlad Maharaj 担心他的父亲下地狱。主尼师大德就告诉他：“因为你是伟大的奉献者，你不用担心，你的上21代祖先都因为你而能得到好处。”Yes,
very good. Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题，喜宝，顶拜咕噜。今天最后一个问题是，几天前为即将离世的无神论大伯 讲述 Krishna 之觉，在取得已经不能说话的临终者眨眼睛表示同意的情况下，我首先给他看了孤的照片，然后是帕帕德照片，最后是 Krishna 的照片，并且告诉他按照这个程序，孤鲁就会带他去圣帕帕德那里，圣帕帕德带他去永恒快乐的灵性世界，临终者眨眼睛表示愿意，最后一个小时平静离开世界。请问这个程序做临终关怀是否合适？感恩。Okay, since the last question for me today is that several days ago, I talk about Krishna consciousness to my nearly departed atheist uncle, big uncle, and the dying person blink his eyes to show he's agreeable, although he cannot speak. First of all, I showed the Guru's picture to him, and then Srila Prabhupada's picture, Krishna's picture. I told him, according to this procedure, Guru can bring him to Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada can bring him to eternal, blissful, spiritual world. And my big uncle blinked his eyes to show he is breathing. And after 1 hour, he passed away peacefully. My question that is this procedure to show careness for the dying person, is it suitable? Thank you.
Well, I think it's better for them in that situation that they simply hear the holy name. Let them hear the holy name, the chanting of the Maha Mantra, and hear some spiritual sound vibration, rather than just, you know, okay, you showed them pictures, but let them hear the holy name. The chanting is very powerful. We have that custom. When people are leaving the body, we will do kirtan. When Srila Prabhupada was leaving the body, all the devotees were in his room, we were all chanting. And one devotee was sitting beside his bed, he was reading out loud the book of his spiritual master. So, okay, you do like that.
So, you do like that.
Shai Gawanti? Chutararan?
Shai Gawanti is Wang Junying. 恶魔是 Asura 吗？ Is a demon's Asura?
Yes.
是的。
There are two kinds of people. There are the devotees and there are the demons.
有两类人，恶魔奉献者。
Devotee means the mode of goodness and the demons mean the mode of passion and ignorance.
奉献者就意味处在善良属性。
下一个问题。
下一个问题是 Harini， 顶拜孤儿莲花族，我是 Gopinath 的 Priya， 在 Harini 家， 我们崇拜 Gauranitai， 如果回归灵性世界，会有什么灵性躯体呢？灵性世界的各种躯体都是平等吗？感恩 Guru。
嗯。
Obeisance Guru's lotus feet and Gopina Zapriya live in Harini's house. We worship Gauranitai if we return back to spiritual world.What kind of spiritual body will we have? Is every all kinds of body in spiritual world equal? Thank you, Guru.
Yes, all kinds of bodies in the spiritual world are equal. There is equality there.
是的，在灵性世界，所有的躯体都是平等的。
And what kind of body you will take when you go back to the spiritual world will depend on your own consciousness, which particular mood, which particular form of the Lord you are attracted to.
至于回归灵性世界，您获得什么样的灵性躯体，这要取决于您的知觉、您的心态以及您受到哪一个形体所吸引。
If you worship Gauranitai, if you're absorbed in Gauranitai, you worship Gauranitai, you think of Gauranitai at the time of leaving the body, then you may go and join Lord Chaitanya on Sankirtan in the spiritual world.
如果您就是专一心一意地想着 Gauranitai 的话，那么您会在灵性世界加入主 Chaitanya 的 Sankirtan。齐颂圣名。
下一个问题。
没有了。那 this is the last question for today.
Okay. Sati, 我们今天到这。
对，我们今天就到这里吧。
Okay. 感谢 Sati, 主持人，感谢 Guru Mani 给我们精彩的翻译，感谢所有的奉献者 Ling Ting, T Wen。祝你们万事如意，传教顺利。Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki, Gaur Premanande.
Hare Krishna. 好，感谢 Guru 的讲课，感谢大家的聆听。Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.